Hello guys, this is Val from Core Conservation, and this video is a follow-up video about some of Peter Ward's business practices from Heritage House. Just wanted to do a follow-up video on this because if you are an old building owner and you're doing your own research on some of the dampness problems or looking for impartial advice, you should know about this because it puts things slightly in a different perspective. We have been working long enough in this industry to know that Peter Ward from Heritage House is a troublemaker, who has been causing trouble, aggravation, or talking badly, not only about us, but a lot of other organizations in the building sector, including the RICS, the Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyors, the SPAB, the Society of Protection of Ancient Buildings, the BBA, the British Board of Agreement, Trustmark, and so on, calling everyone idiots, incompetents, open to bribery, scam, or fraud. If you go onto his website, you are going to find two types of content on Peter Ward's websites. One, all building related things, everything that excludes rising damp. So those are all valid information. They have been in the public domain for decades. These include the concept of breathability, using lime, not using cement, drainage, ventilation, pointing and plastering advice, and so on. It's all basic common sense stuff. Every conservation professional knows about these and applies them. They're kind of the ABC of conservation. All buildings have been built this way for centuries. All this is traditional knowledge and no one can claim copyright on these concepts. However, this can be brand new information from many first-time old building owners who never dealt with an old building before and are looking to overcome, solve and prevent various dampness problems. And this old building related advice on Peter's website is valid and correct. However, his views and recommendations on the topic of rising damp are not true. And secondly, the second type of content you find on his website are rising damp related content, where his message is invariably one, rising damp doesn't exist, it's only condensation. And two, rising damp can't exist on its own, but it's always caused by something else, or it's a result of some sort of building defect, such as high ground, insufficient drainage, cement, pointing, or plastering issues. Guys, both of these statements are nonsense and incorrect. Although other sources of moisture can contribute to rising damp, rising damp can and does occur on its own, and can and does occur in buildings that are perfectly well maintained without any significant neglects or maintenance issues. And the older the building generally, and the thicker the walls, the more obvious these problems become because they are part of the natural aging process. About the existence of rising damp, just look at Venice. It's a conservation area, very strictly regulated, conservation-centric, which receives a lot of attention and funding due to its unique nature. And if you look around, you can see the signs of rising damp all over the place on virtually any building, 2, 3, 4, 5 meters high. Yes, Venice is a special case, but it shows what rising damp can do at its worst. Now, having a different theory on rising damp or seeing things differently in itself, there's nothing wrong with it. If Peter wants to say that rising damp doesn't exist, it's absolutely fine. However, calling every other company who thinks about this differently a fraud or a con is not only unacceptable, but it's illegal. Even more, openly attack and purposefully seek to destroy and discredit everyone who thinks differently, well, that's what Peter does. And this is not my own opinion, this is his own statement about his own activity. He calls himself the destroyer of damp companies, the guy who destroys damp companies. Quite funnily, this is kind of similar to Galileo Galilei, the famous Italian physicist, who 400 years ago has been forced by the Inquisition to withdraw his theory that Earth rotates around the Sun, not vice versa. Something like this would obviously be unacceptable in the 21st century, yet Peter Ward is kind of doing something similar. Now, why is he doing that? What is his motivation? We have made a very interesting discovery in this sense. This is his way of operation, kind of typical way of operation. Let's say you are an old building owner who just purchased an old building. You might have had a home report highlighting some of the dampness problems. So, like everyone else, you go online, go to Google, and try to educate yourself about the dampness, pros and cons of various methods, solutions, and chances are you're going to end up on his website for two reasons. One, because there's a lot of content about old buildings, and two, because if you're looking for rising damp, he has a lot of content about rising damp associated with it, practically any keyword, talking about rising damp as a scam, as a fraud, about the fraud of rising damp, about how bad and controversial this field is. And the interesting thing is, you cannot do research today on old buildings without running into his material. Let's check it out. The first phrase I put into the search engines is dampness in old buildings. These are all phrases which any old building owner would search for. So dampness in old buildings, greenspec.co.uk, and here it is, heritagehouse.org, managing damp problems in old buildings. Then after that again, heritageconsulting.org, damp-proofing old houses. Clicking on any of these links, for example, will take us about to this page, damp-proofing old houses. Salts, external influences, internal moisture, and then says here's a link to the Heritage House website where you can amuse yourself for hours reading about these idiots and the things they do to people. Timber and damp surveys and so on. Costs are for around £900 for a damp survey. Let's click on the Heritage House website, which came up first. Managing damp in old buildings needs to breed. And then fraud of rising damp on the left-hand side. And so on. So you get good information and also you get about his own viewpoints on rising damp. Ultimate proof that rising damp doesn't happen. Actually, just a quick comment here about this particular picture, if it came up on the screen. The wall above the water surface is bone dry. Really? How can you determine that? Do you have X-ray vision? Because in order to assess what is actually occurring inside the wall, how dry or how damp the wall is, you should take core readings from the walls. Just because the surface, we have wind, you have heating and ventilation, it doesn't mean that the core of the wall is dry. It just shows that the surface is dry. So making an assumption here that, hey, the wall is bone dry without actually taking readings, I think is just one of those misleading information out there. And as far as I can tell, here at the bottom, yes, you have about two cores which are completely soaked wet. You can see the green moss, which means that probably you have varying water levels. But I would not call this wall dry without proper measurements, just as a side comment here. Another phrase, here's the second phrase, solving rising damp in old buildings. Okay, that's the second phrase. Heritage House comes in first. Next, research phrase, is damp proof course needed in an old building? Just an innocent phrase, you don't know anything about rising damp. Heritage House comes out first, managing dampness in old buildings, probably comes to the same page. Yeah, the solid wall needs to breathe. Yep. Next phrase we are looking at is dampness in listed building. Newton Waterproofing, these are all commercial companies. Heritagehouse.org, same page, managing damp problems in old buildings. Heritage Consulting, listed building consent. Next one. Stone cottage damp walls. Heritagehouse.org comes out here. Forums, Money Saver, Mumsnet. Again, three Peter Ward videos about PCA damp fraud, damp volley, another damp old house, cement render and plastic paint. Damp walls in an old house, why and how to understand. Again, good information, but pretty trash on rising damp. Another page, heritagehouseconsulting.org. Next one, I've selected condensation in an old building. This obviously Heritage House comes out first. So if you click on it, talks about managing condensation, temperature, humidity. Fair enough. Condensation in old houses causes the phenomenon most commonly called rising damp. So here it is. This is many, many places. Condensation equals rising damp. Guys, this is incorrect. Next one, listed building damp survey, Newton waterproofing, and then again, heritagehouse.org, heritageconsulting.org. We actually already checked these pages, and there's some historic England at the very bottom of the first page. Listed building home survey. Keep going, heritageconsulting.org. Next page, cement in old buildings. And then here we have again, this is the cement, heritagehouse.org. Good, that's it. So as you can see, if you are an old building owner and you start doing any research on old buildings, you are going to run into heritagehouse.org. So virtually, you cannot do research these days on old buildings without running into his false data. Once you get onto his website, in regards to rising damp particularly, his content is about three things. One, false information, particularly that rising damp doesn't exist, or it can't exist on its own, but is due to something else. And quite interestingly, these statements alone will make every other company, every company or every tradesman out there dealing with dampness or rising damp a con, because everyone out there tries to source something which doesn't exist. Everyone becomes a fraud. Two, you are going to find data that instills panic and fear. He takes this whole rising damp proposition one step further. He describes damp proofing as a minefield governed by very bad people and very bad organizations, making you feel insecure, unprotected, and taken advantage of, so you get your guard up. And guys, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that everything is okay out there, that no DPC has ever failed, or there have been no DPC incorrect installations. These things happen, unfortunately. Nobody's 100% correct or perfect out there. People or companies make mistakes. But most people have good intentions, are willing to change and correct things. Not every builder or building company is as bad as he describes. And three, discredits every other professional body or source of information. It tells you you should not trust anyone. Everyone out there is corrupt to some extent because they, the damproofing industry, got everyone. Even the SPAB, the Society of Protection of Ancient Buildings, the oldest heritage group of the UK, who virtually have nothing to do with this. And even more, him, Peter Ward, is the only man standing, the man whom they couldn't get. You see, he has this singular viewpoint, him against everyone out there in disagreement with everyone else. So from his viewpoint, it's a big fight. Everyone is against him, but it's a silly fight. He's picking the fight with everyone else, like, you know, Don Quixote against the windmills. Charging and fighting. So what happens next? He sells you his £1,000 survey plus expenses. And as a side action, he further discredits free surveys as competition, as they are bad for his business, the main business, you know, the paid surveys. He says, free surveys are bad. People who offer free surveys are con and are damproofing salesmen. Guess what? The damproofing industry got them too. Guys, this is ridiculous. It's far from true. It's complete nonsense. A lot of small companies offer free consultation, free estimates, free surveys, or some sort of freebie, either a free product or a free introductory service. Most tradesmen out there offer free estimates. This gives them a chance to interact with potential customer, demonstrate their professionalism and competence, then win business and grow and stand up against the big boys, the big companies. This is an accepted practice throughout every business sector. Many architects, for example, offer free consultation to clients to start a discussion and make a personal interaction with many of them. And guess what? Architects are not salesmen. They are probably the opposite. I have been dealing with many of them personally. They are very soft, very consultational, very friendly, very much service-oriented, yet they offer free consultations. Now, his solution is basically he does the survey, writes a report, and offers generic concepts. Breathability, use of lime, don't use cement, heating, ventilation. Otherwise, live with it. Again, these are fundamentals of building conservation, old traditional, nothing new to a professional. And we have clients who did the lime, did the drainage, we did everything the traditional ways, and this did not have the rising dam problem sorted. And they come back within a few years and says, you know what, I have done this, I have done the replastering, and the problem is not gone, has reappeared. And if by any chance, if you're one of these guys out there who tried all these traditional approaches except the damp-proof course and the problem came back, feel free to reach out to us and we can help you. I also would like to address here the question of price or value, because Peter has been accusing not only us but other damp-proofing companies or technologies that they are expensive and they take up a lot of money and they charge a lot of money. Pretty much the message is everyone is expensive except his surveys, which are obviously a very good value. He does a survey and report, charges £1,000-£1,500 with VAT and travel expenses for this. About us, our working process in particular, we offer a comprehensive survey and report. We install our damp-proofing technology by a highly trained engineer and we send another report. Then we follow up the problem and follow up the building with further visits for about 2 years, sometimes more, overall averaging 5 or more interactions with a client. And in a residential building, for all this, we charge about the same as a traditional DPC, and customers are happy because we solve their problems promptly and professionally. And if you have any doubts, just listen to some of the testimonials on coreconservation.co.uk. Overall, we are very good value. Our services include both physical products and long-term professional services. And Peter talking badly about this or talking disparagingly about this just shows his complete ignorance about what we do. He's so arrogant, he created a DampComp collection on his website, calling virtually every technology out there addressing the problem of rising damp a con and non-workable. Without any proof or investigation, by the way, just on a whim, just telling a bunch of lies about everyone. For example, he first published his first article about ourselves, calling us a scam over a year ago, without ever meeting or interacting with us, just from the anonymity of the internet, you know, from his basement. And we are the only company who approached him openly with a sense of fair play and offered him a free trial. We were stupid enough, as he called us or labeled us, to do that, because we genuinely thought that this guy is just misinformed, but overall, he's a good guy. He's kind of weird and impulsive and kind of shoots from his hip before he talks, but you know these people, you get these people occasionally, kind of oddballs, but harmless. No malice, no bad intention, basically it's a good intention with false information. So we were happy to talk to him and show him genuinely what we do and how we operate. Fast forward 16 months, what he did? He did not let us go back to gather any first-hand evidence or progress on dehydration. He has taken the unit down, created a show about it, littered with false information, disassembled it, calling us a scam, publishing another video of lies, about us. But before doing that, he did a walkthrough of his cellar with a camera, telling how dry his cellar actually is. Quite interesting, isn't it? We had the unit in for 16 months, and he does a follow-up video telling how nothing wrong is with his cellar. Yet, he keeps puking lies about us, calling us and our technology a scam. Just think about it, how stupid this is. He had the perfect setup. We had a system installed in his basement. All he had to do is just let us go back and show no progress, and he would have had the perfect story. Yet, he didn't do it because why? Because he deep inside, he felt, he knew that he would have been discredited based on the results, or at least two counts. One, if our technology works, something he called a scam, he would have been a liar, talking garbage all the way. And two, most importantly, this would have proved that Rising Dump does exist and something can be done about it, which would have been a blow to his professional career. Everything he built, everything he stood for a decade, turns out to be incorrect and lies. As the Japanese say, he would have lost his face. Just this morning, he uploaded another trash article onto his website, tweeting about us in a negative way, picking on some of the typos he's found on our website. Guys, apologies for that. These occasionally happen, obviously shouldn't happen, but he's picking on now on the typos. Well, that's his scorecard. That's who he is. That's what he does now and going forward until he gets bored or he's forced to stop. Now, after this whole trial proposition, based on the way he behaved, he made us very clear that this is not about being right or wrong. It's not about impartial journalism. For him to provide impartial and objective information to his followers, to the old building owners, obviously, about the topic of rising damp and available remedies and solutions. And it's probably safe to assume that at this point, that his story about this vague, hidden, large-scale, secret, damp-proof industry plot is on pretty shaky grounds, and at best is a half-truth littered with lies, adapted and tweaked in a direction to serve his own twisted agenda, because, as he has proven many times, he's a public liar. It's pure malice and evilness with the intention to harm, discredit, or belittle others, professionals or companies who don't agree with his views, either because of some financial benefit, or, I don't know, just his twisted enjoyment. And this is completely against any British fair play, any British values, or any business ethics. Now, think about this, guys. Just because you disagree with someone, any person, professionally or personally with someone, you don't have to hate them. You don't have to harm them on a wide scale, spreading lies about them. You know, people can get carried away in a discussion, in a heat of a discussion, and then cool down, step back, apologize, and say, hey, sorry, man. And the problem is sorted. But Peter Ward does all this, all his lies, attacks, smear campaigns, cold-bloodedly, in a calculated way, long-term, day in, day out, as a long-term strategy. It's not about impulse, it's a long-term strategy, purposefully. He hides behind the anonymity of the internet, putting out scandalous articles, blaming everyone, knowing it better than everyone, and generally not replying to any or most communications from the parties he's spoken badly about it. He does not do constructive discussions, period. Just blame, malice, and destruction. It's a fact of life that all buildings which have no DPCs will always be subject to some dampness. If nothing else, due to the wet British climate and aging, and having no DPC, they will need some sort of solution to bring them up to the 21st century standards. So, The various damproofing solutions are not going to go away. And if they would, just think about this, guys, if this whole country would be if this whole country would be left without any damproofing technology, I think we would be in trouble. Imagine us overnight without roofers, carpenters, or plasterers, without the professional knowledge. And as long as anyone in the future will attempt to deal with dampness, especially with rising damp, or think about this subject differently from Peter Ward, he's automatically going to become a target. Just bear this aspect in mind while doing your own research and evaluating what approach is best for your building. So, in closing, summarizing the key concepts. Peter Ward is knowledgeable about old buildings, but completely incompetent in the topic of rising damp, which according to him does not exist. False data number one, rising damp can't exist on its own, but must be related to some sort of building defect. False data number two, rising damp is condensation, so all his solutions are about handling condensation, ignoring rising damp. His way of operation is the following. He grabs your attention, instills panic, uncertainty, and fear, discredits other professional bodies in order to become the sole expert in this space, sells you his £1,000 survey, and tells you you never need a damproof course, but lime, ventilation, heating, etc. will solve everything. And obviously for commercial reason, discredit and attacks free surveys. Most importantly, actively and maliciously seeks to destroy everyone who does not agree with his ideas professionally. Don't be fooled, guys. He's not just an eccentric, harmless guy. No. When it comes to the topic of rising damp, he becomes obsessed, destructive, and malicious. He's not only targeting damp companies, but the whole building industry. On the topic of rising damp, he has a singular viewpoint in this space, going against everyone out there. Architects, universities, research organizations, conservation professionals, old textbooks, mainstream physics and science, ignores or attacks everyone who says rising damp does exist and it's a valid phenomenon. His lies during the past decade created significant confusion in the building industry, making everyone's life more difficult, including all buildings owners, due to the many misleading information. Guys, that should be mainly it. We care about old buildings, we understand old buildings, we never picked this fight, we never wanted this fight, we're just replying to some of these ridiculous claims. We are a company meaning its own business, we are looking after our customers and their old buildings, we go the extra mile. We are being open and transparent and professional. As always, I hope you found this useful. Please do your own research and do what is true for you or what you think is best for you or for your building under the given circumstances. So, if for you there's no rising damp, then it's not a problem. Don't worry about it. However, on the other hand, if you have tried all the traditional approaches, heating, ventilation, lime plastering, and so on, and did not provide you with a good enough long-term solution without combining these traditional solutions with a damproof course, then feel free to get in touch and we can help you. Feel free to comment, subscribe, and share this if you found it useful. Thank you very much for watching. Until later.